presence. I'm taken by the wonder of you. Here inside your glory, we give our lives fully to you.
Let's sing it again.
Here inside your presence, I'm taken by the wonder of you.
To get an album ready for Jesus Culture, the last few actually have been somewhat, believe it or not, last minute. We've kind of rushed, and as far as rehearsals and stuff, this one that you are watching now, we got a little more time in and got a little more creative with, as far as you'll hear some loops and different things that Ian, our keyboard player, does, and just a little more arrangements as far as the songs. So we put a little more time in that. We all get together in a rehearsal space. It was more like a warehouse, but we call it a rehearsal space. And 60 hours later and a lot smellier, we came out with the finished product, so. Summer's pretty busy. We've got a lot of traveling going on and starting to write for my solo project that hopefully we'll start tracking later this fall. And, doing a lot of writing with Jeffrey and our guitar player and one of my good friends. So we're all getting married and it's a busy summer. So writing's in between that and hopefully be tracking and have an album at least started somewhere near the beginning of winter. So the song Obsession is on this current album and finally made it. I've been wanting to do that song on any of our albums for like 3 or 4 years. The song kind of means a lot to me personally. Just like the chorus kind of, for me, sums up, you know, what we're all about, just as a people, like our hearts just burning for God, and that's kind of our one desire and one passion. So I was really excited that Banning agreed to letting us put it on there, and pretty excited about the way the song turned out. So we have a few originals on this current album. I wrote one of the ones, Burning Ones, with Jeffrey. Jeffrey helped me with the music, and the idea kind of came, I just kind of was worshiping, and the bridge, Burning Ones, came into my, We Are Your Burning Ones, came into my mind, and I kept singing that over, and just kind of wrote it down, and put a little scratch thing in GarageBand, and set it aside. And then later when we started coming with song, like thinking of songs for the new album, I showed it to Jeffrey and he kind of helped me put some music to it. And the song just kind of developed from there. Jeremy Edwardson, our producer, helped with just a lot of the arranging of it, and I think it turned out pretty well.
By you. Sing it.
A lot of cover songs, I'm sure most of you guys have noticed, on our albums, and part of the reason is we have a lot of songs that are kind of fueling our movement locally at our church, and it really started out, Jesus Culture started out of our youth group, and we had an idea to just record the songs that kind of meant a lot to us as a youth group and just as a church. So a lot of the songs that are on the albums are songs that personally ministered to us or to our congregation, and we just kind of want to get those out there to people that may not have heard them, so we can have our own little twist or take on the song.
We set our lives up. We are consumed.
Let's sing it again. We are your burning ones.
God. We give you our hearts completely, Lord. Consume every part of us. Lift up your voices. Consume every part of us, Father. Consume every part of us, God. You're our one desire, Lord.
Prophetic and spontaneous worship. For me, they're kind of two different things. The spontaneous worship is just it's the worship that's the overflow of what's in my heart. It's the worship that at any moment and any time of the day, I can stop what I'm doing and just give my love and my affection and my attention to God. You know, the well inside of me that I'm constantly keeping filled up and overflowing, and it's just that overflow. The spontaneous worship is me just singing my heart, my affection to God. Something will come out, and right in that moment, I feel the anointing, I feel that excitement, and that to me is like something was just released, like that was a prophetic moment. The prophetic worship is a worship that something comes out of you that comes from a deep place that is releasing the grace for something to happen in that moment. The worship actually releases a grace in the atmosphere for people to come into that moment or come into something or get free of something. I have a lot of value for songs. I just kind of look at them a little different. I sing the songs and it kind of helps get me to that spontaneous flow. And then in the flow is when the prophetic moment will come. Worship for Jesus Culture is probably one of our biggest core values that we have. And for us, worship is all about the encounter with God. You know, we're not there to just sing songs. We're not there to put on a good show. We're there because we truly believe that every time we come into worship, that we are going to have an encounter with God. We're going after that. You know, worship is, it's our time and our opportunity to give back to God and to give Him love and glory and to just worship Him and love Him. And being the faithful, amazing God that He is, He always pours out His love in return and He always meets us there. And you know, sometimes the encounters are, you just feel His presence, and sometimes it's this radical life-changing, you're thrown on the floor and you're, you know, your whole world's turned upside down. But every time He's there.
You are faithful, my God, for I know.
I think for churches that are wanting to have Jesus Culture type worship in their churches, the number one thing to remember is just the passion. You know, we put a lot of passion into what we do. We're passionate about our worship. We're passionate about what we're doing. We're passionate about God. We're passionate about loving Him. And we don't want to hold back or have any restrictions. And it doesn't take a large band or fancy lights or any of that for that to happen. It's about positioning your heart in a place of unbridled passion that is just fully released to God and ready to just come into His presence and really encounter Him. Our goal with the DVDs in recording the worship and making it to where it's available and people can watch that is so that people can have that same encounter at home, at wherever they are, wherever you're watching it, on the plane, wherever it is. But it's not, it's not about a show. It's not about just something just to watch for entertainment, but it's something that we all as a team have poured into, and not just, you know, our hours or our time, our gifts, but just our love and our prayers and our hope that that the DVD will actually just bring people into an encounter with God, that there would even be people who maybe have never experienced God or met God that would see those and to see something real. And I just feel like, you know, people know real, they know authentic, and that's what we're all hungry for, Christian and non-Christian alike. We want real, we want authentic, and that's what we're trying to bring. We're trying to bring the real, the tangible, and this is just one outlet and just a resource that we want to make available to people so that they can have that encounter with God, so that they have something in their hands, they can pop it in and the worship starts and they get taken there into God's presence and really encounter Him and have the real and the tangible experience, whether they were there the night of the recording or not. It's about His presence and about just encountering Him.
For I know You are faithful, my God. For I know You are faithful, my God. Every voice, sing it out. For I know I declare, I declare, for I know You are faithful, my God.
I really like this album because I feel like the musically, the time that we took to make this album more creative and to make it more really a part of who we are really comes through. And I think that just the level of musicality in this album is far beyond what we've ever done before. And even just the DVD and just the moment that was captured on that night, I think is way bigger than we've done before and more ambitious, and I feel like it really has paid off with what we've done. I think that the way that the songs flow on this album are a lot smoother. I think that they really communicate how each one of us is in worship and what each one of us carries, and it really is combined together to make a full experience that makes you just want to listen to it over and over again. So I think that's the main reason why this album is my favorite. When I'm interacting with the band and trying to make a song that we've picked for the CD kind of make it our own and also put, you know, just who we are inside of it, we kind of just do it the way that it was originally, and then we just kind of throw out ideas, things we like about it, things we don't like about it, things that we think would make it sound better, and just kind of run through it that way. And then also we just kind of let ourselves think outside of the box with the way the song was originally written and recorded, not getting away from the integrity of the song, but just being able to expand upon it and make it better. And also just really being able to communicate who we are and the different things that we like about music throughout that song. Like Oh Lord, You're Beautiful, we took an old song and we kind of made it more more relevant and more modern with the arrangement, as well as just kind of making it more of a feel song where you can actually feel the Holy Spirit just kind of moving and taking you to a different place than you did before.
You don't want to come?
Yeah, I want to come.
Well, then come on.
Let's go. Taking my car or your car?
My car. My car rocks, dude.
What do you have?
I got the four whammy cylinder on the floor.
Bank of the West.
Slamming with dual shocking.
Let's go.
Shocks. The rotary girder. That's awesome. I got Tommy muffler left. Bearings, stock, not stock.
Let's go. This way. Listen, if somebody attacks you, it's just a backhand now. Bam! Game over.
Totally.
Hey, listen, he said you like to watch too. There's
what?
Three out of the four family members are for it.
Well, the best brother you ever had. That's quite a character.
The good news is I was like 100 feet away and he didn't know what time it is, so I just looked over and.
Oh, and we need to work out what we're going to do if we're going to go.
You for my love.
You wrote the song Burning Ones on the album. As a songwriter, how do you start in the songwriting process?
Burning Ones came from me sitting in the sun doing an interview. It was burning hot.
Take it to the ring.
You are my fire, my water. Desire. Tell me why it ain't nothing but a part.
Thank you.
Can you check your check the console, make sure we're 1-1?
Put it like more.
No, when you put that close.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah, don't do that. Where's your flip? Oh, that's HD too.
He's over there. Go get him.
This works.
Look, he fell asleep.
Behind the scenes, this is what happens. A human swing.
Some people spend money for baby swings. I got a natural one, it's called Arms. Oh, got him.
It means that I'm bad.
It means that you can't get knocked out. The old guys don't get knocked out.
Right. For real. They fight through the grab.
No,
the grab places.
For real. No. Not even the big part, just the.
Go ahead and record.
What? What'd you say?
What?
What's your name?
You want me to start talking?
Don't
hit me in the head with that thing. Did you just see that come like flying at me? I'm gonna get like poked in the eye, knocked out. You're gonna be in trouble if you give me a black eye before my wedding. No, you'll be in big trouble. Okay, can I just start talking?
Yeah.
How do we connect with the band as a band? Sorry, start over. You're right. It's that fish. There's just flies congregating around me. How do we connect as a band? We all get along pretty well. We're all really good friends, and we like to drive around in cars. How do we connect as a band? We all... We're being invaded. How do we connect as a band? We're all pretty good friends. We all hang out a lot, play video games together. Between conference sessions, don't tell Jerry, but work out together a lot. That one's good. We're done. We connect. We're tight. Fishing, basket weaving.
Oh no!
Enough. Just toxic. That's what the boss says.
Okay, send me in the middle,
please. I'm really gonna
need it. It's okay, it's pretty good. Yeah, go that way. Hit the Chevy.
Wait, which one?
That felt much better this time.
You guys walk that way, Paul.
Towards the car.
Angle it in, there you go.
Right.
We need another guy.
Whoa.
Hold on, don't flip.
Yeah.
Christine's bad.
Hey Joe, were we gonna need those two mic stands from Bethel?
It just got thrashed, dude.
So we're just gonna epoxy him?
Worst idea.
Alright, everyone will call you back in 10 minutes.
No, they are all leaving. They're on break. It's me and you from here on out.
How do you feel about your rail design?
Sensor rack. You can't, it's not hiding.
Well, it's not really my design, but it's between me and you.
Can you go around the front?
You want to flip it around?
No, wait a minute.
No. What's the plan?
Plan is if we can't fix these five brakes that we have.
No, I want to know if he still wants it on the wall. Did you not weld it on?
How can we weld inside? That's why I said we needed to stop.
No. Which bolt? Did it come off?
Right here.
Like three of them came off. Yeah. I don't know how it got so screwed up with 11 people.
All that stuff up next week.
It'll pull. Yeah. We'll go buy some other stuff too. We'll glue the crap out of it.
For some reason, these holes aren't lining up with that.
Cool.
See how it's staggered?
You guys need any help?
On the intercom? Oh,
we haven't got enough help.
Got it.
Why?
Hey, where'd that socket go?
I think that's the light.
Here, let's find a strip that does then.
Let's make a double strip that does, you know?
Why don't we have the double?
Hey, Joe, do you know where those mics went?
The mics at the cable. Hi, Joe.
pizza.
The length is right here.
Because I'm going to make two that are exact.
Oh, okay. This is the
one. Oh, wait, you did it.
This one's up here. Good job.
Consumed, we are consumed by you. We said.